What is liquid cooling? Knocking over a filled Coca-Cola bottle into your PC is not considered liquid cooling, at least not a sustainable one. No, liquid cooling is something else. There are two types of liquid cooling. The custom ones, like this PC right here, and the much more affordable AIOs, which stands for all-in-one, closed circuit liquid cooling, like this. Not as big of a flex, but still pretty decent. So why do we need to cool our PC? Well, hardware generates a lot of heat, especially a CPU. So you need to get the heat from the CPU away from the hardware. If you don't manage to disperse the heat, that means the hardware will become too hot and it will end up throttling lower its calculating capabilities. The performance will drop. This is a built-in safe mechanic to prevent permanent damage on the hardware. So when we connect a liquid cooler or an air cooler to the CPU, this will help disperse the heat that's been generated by the CPU and it will allow it to perform as it should. Now, I did mention air cooling, which is an alternative to liquid cooling, but I will get back to that later. First off, let's dive into how this actually works. So inside this, we have a pump and we have the liquid, which is in most cases distilled water and propylene alcohol. It is completely filled. Well, almost. There are still a few air bubbles in here. We'll get back to that, I promise you. So with the pump head connected to the CPU, the heat from the CPU will be transferred into the water. The hot water will then travel to the radiator over here. It will siphon through these fins, and then when it's been cooled down, it will come out and into the pump again, closing the circuit. You attach fans to a radiator like this, so the hot air that's been generated in these fans due to the hot water will be pushed out of the case, like so. This one can hold three fans, so you consider this a 360 millimeter. There are also 240 millimeters like this one, where you can have two fans, and in this case we have a 120 millimeter with a mounted fan already. So what is the difference between an AIO liquid cooler like this and an air cooler? I'm actually not doing the air coolers a favor by showing this. This is a stock cooler that you get when you purchase one of the smaller CPUs from Intel. So this is decent enough if you have a small i3 or in some cases i5 processor. But if you go further than that, you will end up with a CPU that's generating too much heat for this little fan to actually handle. So the alternative is the much bigger thing like this, where you can actually mount three fans, one on this side, one in the middle, and one on the other side. I actually read somewhere a pretty nice comparison. It is comparing liquid coolers to air coolers. It's like comparing a sofa and a regular chair. You can both sit in them, but they serve two different purposes. And it's kind of like the same with cooling your system. There is the obvious aesthetic choice. Many people prefer the liquid cooler over the air cooler because it looks more sleek. And this one is pretty bulky. So if you have a smaller case, you wouldn't be able to use this big bulky one. It's basically too deep. Now you can get them low profile with a shorter heat sink. Then there's the noise level. If you end up with a big air cooler like this, the Noctua coolers, the Be Quiet air coolers, they all have great performance and pretty low noise level. If you compare that to a liquid cooler with three fans, you will end up with a somewhat higher noise level. To me, it's marginal, but it matters to some people. One of the issues you might experience with a big heatsink like this is that it takes up a lot of space in your case. Now, we covered that. If you have deep enough space, case for this, it's not an issue, but it will in some cases hinder your access to your motherboard. It might actually block some PCI lanes or the memory place. We don't call it RAM slot anymore. We try to avoid slot shaming. Having a smaller case might affect the ambient temperature in your case with an air cooler like this. Whereas the liquid cooler will be directly mounted in the case so that you will have fans pushing it directly out of the case, so you don't rely on the fans in the case to actually push out the air. Now, this might sound like a small thing, but it is being vividly discussed what is better. Well, I'm not here to make judgments, I'm just lining out some differences between the two. To me, it comes down to a personal preference thing. You can get air coolers that perform really, really well, and you can get liquid coolers that perform really well. You will get a little bit lower noise level with the air coolers if they are good, and if you have room for it in your build, that could also make sense. To other people, the aesthetics of the liquid coolers is so much more of a thing. And if you do like a pretty neat build like this, the air cooler will be your choice. An AIO like this does persist of many more moving parts than the air cooler like this. So in theory, it will have a more tendency to break. Now, I will quickly add that here at Shark Gaming, we've built almost 100,000 computers over the span of a decade. And it is a very rare occurrence to actually see AIO coolers break. One of the concerns that we hear people have with AIO coolers is that it's a liquid and you shouldn't mix liquid with electronic parts. What if it breaks or leaks or permeates and liquid will drop into my graphics card and break it? Permeation and leaks from a liquid cooling system like this is extremely rare. It's considered mythical here at Shark Gaming. We've built computers for a decade. We've done the RMA on the computers and all that time. And whenever we see people have complaints about an AIO, it is because of noise levels. A few times it's because of reduced efficiency. Mostly it's noise. It's almost never because of permeation or leaks. So I'm gonna kill that myth right here and right now. Now, there's an elephant in the room that I've wanted to tackle since the get-go, but I've been patient. Next to people asking to get free PCs, this is the comment that we receive the most. You might have seen Gamers Nexus make a video about how you should place your AIO and how you shouldn't. You might also have seen Jay's Two Cents come to the rescue of those who place AIOs in a certain way. If you don't listen closely, it does sound like Gamers Nexus is telling us that this is forbidden. You should never mount it like this, right? Well, Jay's Two Cents actually made a video about this saying that this is okay and actually went in depth explaining why this is so. If you want to see those videos, we'll leave links at the end of our video, but I wanted to tackle that as well here. As we mentioned before, the pump up here and the radiator up here, down here, over here, are two separate things. Now, there are bubbles in this closed system. You have to have bubbles in there. It's almost impossible to make this product without having some bubbles in there. And due to water expanding when exposed to different heat, having bubbles in there is actually a good thing. So, when you mount your pump head over your radiator, the bubbles in the system will travel up the tube and will end up being stuck here at the pump head. This will cause damage to your pump and will lower the efficiency and life expectancy of the product. Now, what many misunderstood in the Gamers Nexus video was when he made this placement many people thought that the case still applied here, that this was also caused damage and lowered life expectancy of your system. Having a system placed like this does not lower life expectancy, it does not lower performance. The only bad thing that this will do is that the bubbles might get trapped up here, causing some bubble noises. As long as the pump head is lower than the top of the radiator, there's no issue at all. So if you mount it like this, there's no issue. If you mount it like this, there's no issue. If you mount it like this, there's no issue. So the difference between mounting it like this, this, and this is the fact that bubbles can get stuck up here when you're mounting it with the tubes up like this. Now, in many cases, you cannot mount it like this. There's no room for it. And in many cases, you do not have room for placing it like this. You can't fit the tubes down here without causing damage to the tubes. So the only issue with placing it like this is the fact that you can get some bubble noises. That's it. He does mention this in Gamers Nexus, but it's not very clear, and I think that's partially why J2Sense made the response video acknowledging the fact this is okay. This is best. This is okay. This is okay. So you actually don't get the bubble noises if you're mounting it like this. You won't get the bubble noises if you're mounting like this. But there's no performance issues or difference between these two. There are some that has done some anecdotal tests where they have tested a dozen computers, seeing that you will get a slightly lower CPU temperature if you mount it like this compared to this. But if you're only testing a dozen computers, it will remain anecdotal. It is not a big enough sample size to actually be able to conclude anything about it. We don't know what kind of silicon lottery you might be ending up with. Is one graphics card or one CPU better than the other? That's kind of one of the things that we can't really see when we are faced with tests like that. I can, however, say that with around 100,000 computers built and RMA cases where we see all kinds of different things that fail, often it's hardware that fails. It can be a CPU or the graphics card, it can be the motherboard, RAM often, it can be a power supply. It's almost never this that's faulty. And if it's faulty, it's because it's making noises. There's no performance hindering, there's no leakage. So this is, as a product in a case, it is pretty damn good. And that concludes our little video on this subject here. If you have any questions about this, or if you would be able to fit miniature sharks in a closed loop system, please ask them in the comments down below. We would be happy to answer both the first and the latter of these questions. We have been looking into that. Like and subscribe if you found this video useful, and give me a high five if you see me out there in the real world. I love high fives.